Thank you. Yes. Oh, Isunokami. It's good to see you. Well, okay.
What is it?
Hey. I see.
Hey there!
Yes.
A moment of your time?
Huh? Okay.
Yes?
I see. It's true.
you're back. I take it you've made some progress in your investigation. Let's hear your report.
We heard a lot of reports about a fortune teller and a large crow at the sites where people turned to salt.
A fortune teller and a large crow. So it sounds like these two points are confirmed.
How can you be so sure?
As it would happen, we've found more humans turned to salt in this area since I sent you to investigate.
From what we've heard, it seems like all of the victims had contact with a fortune teller.
There have also been reports of a large crow being sighted close to the scene. Given the similarities between the intel we've both gathered, it's unlikely this is a coincidence. The culprit must be a demon, or someone working for demons.
We also heard that the victims felt sick before they turned to salt.
Well, unless we can confirm that all victims felt sick before turning, we'll consider it hearsay for the time being. In any case, after reviewing what we know, that crow definitely seems suspicious. I'm going to have Hayataro track it down. That should give us a good lead. Bethel, Japan will know as soon as there are any developments. In the meantime, you can all return to the dorm for the day. Good work. Thanks for your report.
Young man, are you all right? You haven't had time to rest since before we left for Dot. I see. You're stronger than I realized then. But I'm relieved to hear it. But something troubles me. We saw those students turn to salt at the ferry village in Dot. Now, the same thing seems to be happening in Tokyo. Two separate incidents across two worlds. Do you believe the attacks are connected? With a perfect match of such hyper-specific circumstances, it does seem likely that the same culprit is behind both. A fortune teller named Agra and a crow of crows spotted nearby. These clues will lead us to the truth. In any case, we can only wait for Hayataro's report. We'll decide our next move after that. After all you've endured, you must be tired beyond words. Use the remaining hours of today to rest.
Human lives are so woefully short. They forget, and they have lost the peace that once was. It is a most regrettable truth. No more are the days in which the humans of old lived free. No more do they worship Great Mother Earth. Nahobino, this world in which you must live was brought into being when a god rose and assumed the throne. The gods clash over its power, and the victor rules a world in their image. Such is the cycle. Each in their time to mold the world as they will. And yet, the god of this world, the creator, still he was not satisfied with the way things had been. He broke the cycle in a bid to perpetuate his rule. He stripped the gods of their knowledge, reducing them to lowly demons. So he rose, the one and only ruler of the world, his reign infinite and unchallenged. As time flowed on, more came to pass. The people of his world followed him, imposing their will on others beneath. With rule came royalty, and the world split. Those with power, and those without. You can see clearly that the world is fractured now. On one side, the oppressors, and on the other side, the oppressed, yes. We, the Kadishtu, abhor this divide. We seek only to bring this world freedom again.
How are you feeling? If you're all right, then let's head to Bethel, Japan. Maybe they can tell us something.
Let's go! Strike!
Perchance.